Hello darlings, it's Tess. If you don't know me, I am a rainbow witchy creative mess. I usually live in Sydney, but I'm currently down in Hobart staying with my father, and I've got a little situation here in my room that's a lot more interesting than my room has been in the past. So I don't know what the point of this video is going to be. I went to the market this morning, Salamanca Market. You guys, I took you with me to that market years ago. So maybe I can dig up that video and link it down below. But it's an incredibly famous market here in Hobart. It's held every single Saturday. So I went and got some things, presents for other people. I got a present for my mum and some presents for my brother and his wife, who are now over in Hobart.
Oh my god, Tess, they are in Finland. Finland, not Hobart.
So my mother can take their presents to them when she visits this year. But I got some things for myself as well, and I've been kind of sitting here figuring everything out. Sometimes I just want to show you me having fun, so let's do that. So last time I was in this room, it looked vastly different. Let's just say the bed was not here, it was against that wall where the papers now are, and it certainly did not have this four-poster situation. That is because it is being used to store some stuff up here. So there we go, that's interesting. Giant DVD collection is still in here, however, as is the scary masky faces on the wall. But this is my bed, and so I spend every night feeling like a princess, but also hoping that nothing falls on my head. I've got some things over here that I've brought to do while I'm down here. I am watching Bondi Rescue, which I've been addicted to for ages now. I think you guys know that. I've got my three grimoires to kill time, and then all of this is content over here. Oh no, I dropped one. All of this here is content that's gonna go in the grimoires in the pages I haven't finished. And then this folder and this folder are just like random art bits that I can kind of put also into the grimoires. So that's the situation here. Let me show you a couple of other things. So this is my pin board. I have not had one before when I've stayed down here, but I have put some decorations up. I did when I was here last time, because staying for an extended period with no decorations up was just making my eye twitch, so I decided to put up some decor. I love it an awful lot. And then down here, because I'm doing all of my collage work with my folders, a bunch of stuff that I have is collage kits. There are a few. This one, and this one are from Frankie magazine. All the rest of these are from Rookie Mag, and I've printed them out. So instead of thinking to myself while doing a collage and, you know, thinking, okay, I've got my like specific magical content out of here that I printed for the page, I've got some decoration stuff in here, I've got some decoration stuff in here, I've got watercolor, but if it still needs a little something, this means I can look for that little something really, really easily, rather than having to flip through the folder every time. So now I can just look at this and just say, okay, this page that I'm doing about flower magic, why don't I add this? But I haven't thought of doing this before. I could maybe even do it at home. Like, I'm now that I think about it, I'm amazed that I've never thought to do this. Yes, so that's my brainwave for this particular Hobart trip. If anyone's watched my Hobart vlogs before slash knows anything about me, you know that your girl has the biggest sweet tooth on the entire planet. And so one of the stalls that I always go to rainbow boiled lolly jars and big freckles and fresh coconut ice and biscuits with sprinkles. It's just the most beautiful old-fashioned place. And so obviously I got some stuff. So let's just get it out. Happy flowers. I have never tried these before. I'm sure they're just regular gummy. But as soon as I saw them, I knew I had to have them. I got my favorite ever. I feel like every country on earth calls these something different. In Australia, we call it a freckle. This is a specialty of the shop. This particular shop makes giant freckles. Tastes like, shaped like Tasmania. So here's mine, and that's just for me. But then I will obviously share these with the rest of the household. And the last thing I got that will also be good is these. They are watermelon dolphins. Now, the only thing that would make them more perfect is if they were watermelon crocodile. My next task that I want to do that, you know, hopefully we can find some cuteness in there, is I'm going to put my flowers and my freckles and my dolphins into a candy jar, because at the top of our pantry here in Hobart there are about 50,000 empty jars. Stealing one for while I'm here, and I'm gonna put this candy in it, and chances are it's gonna look very fucking adorable. Okay guys, it is now Sunday morning and me and my dad are about to go down to Farmgate, which is the Hobart farmers market. We're going to find some coffee, we're going to find some, you know, whatever they have there. It's just the food central. You're gonna come down with us. Hopefully we'll have a bit of fun. And then I'm going to take you guys back here, and now that there's more daylight today than when I was filming last afternoon, there are a few things that I want to show you now that the light is better.
One of my favorite like tweets or internet posts that I've ever seen is it must have been so weird for the people who discovered mushrooms, because, you know, a third of them would kill you, a third of them are perfectly nice to eat, and a third of them make you see God for a week. I feel like standing at that stall, like you could almost, like, I just imagine myself as being like a cave person and staring at them and just thinking, which one of these is it?
Okay, we're back, and I had a very nice coffee while we were down there. I had a mocha that actually had real chocolate in it, like chips at the bottom. And there is something I want to show you, which is one of my most recent spreads in my grimoire. And I feel like I really want to show you because I intended for it to be kind of a really good art spell. And instead it's just come out kind of like, and I think it's important still to acknowledge pieces that you make, whether you're an art journaler or in this case an art witch, pieces that come out that you don't really like. Like, I just think it's really important to still do that. So I want to show you guys the details of this because chances are when I do a proper flip through of this grimoire in future, I'm not exactly gonna want to go through this page in any detail because I don't really like it, but I'm gonna show you it now. I'm going to be brave. I'm going to let you see my imperfect process and my just the stuff that I am not that proud of, because that's how you get better. So the idea was that I wanted to have this Molly Roberts coloring spell be the middle of it, and have it be road opener, that's what it says. And a road opener spell is basically when you want to open a new path and kind of get out of your own way, so to speak. And I just wanted to echo that really desperately. And I also wanted to bring in some of the things that were just really beautiful and inspiring me. So one of them is this Frida Kahlo The Flower piece, which you guys saw in my exhibition vlog when I took you there. And then this over here is, that's General Ortega on the set of Wednesday, and this is the guy who does the Hand of Thing. And they're on Enid's bed and it's all colourful, so I just really loved this. And so then I've just kind of hit it with other stuff that I thought was really beautiful and inspiring. But in the end, I can't tell you exactly what I don't like, but it's just not doing it for me. So there are a bunch of patches here that are sequined by King Sophie's World, and they all came from a jacket, and I cut them up so that they were like stickers. So that's one, Purple Crystal, that's one, Rainbow Rose, that's a planet, where are the others? That's like a heart with a vagina on it, lol. And that's the top one that says Psychic Babe with an eye, and I love that the eye is brown because I have brown eyes. This sort of Victorian flower woman is from my one of my antiquarian sticker books. Oh, that's another King Sophie's World patchy thing from the jacket. Underneath here is a rainbow crystal from my like mystical magical sticker book that was in my current favorites. I wanted the rainbow, but I don't know, it just looks weird. Fiery sorty thing by Closet Planner Addict. Oh, that's another King Sophie's actually. Sparkly potion bottle, Closet Planner Addict, Lace and Whimsy, I think. Just my favorite, sort of stained glass looking stickers from just Kino Kanuya. There's one there, one there, one there. Butterfly down here. I'll just prop this up a bit, hang on. And nice little birdie. That's another King Sophie's sequin. Cleansing wand down here. But I just like, I just wanted it to be really perfect to pay tribute to the spell in the middle, and I just have ended up not liking it. Oh, there's a goldfish here as well to pay tribute to François, my fishy. But anyway, I wanted to show you this in case you like it, but yeah, I've done better than this, I think. Okay, darlings, here we have the altar in the corner of my desk. Here is the one, the only, the legendary Daenerys, my good luck dragon that I bought in 2014. And next to her, we have a brand new addition to the squad. This little felt beagle I picked up at Salamanca for $9. And as soon as I saw him, I knew I had to have him. But I love beagles, but I'm not allowed a dog in our apartment, so this is the closest I'll have. And I absolutely love him. And I've named him Johnny, after Johnny Cade from The Outsiders, because in The Outsiders, Ponyboy says that Johnny is like a little puppy who's been kicked too many times and is lost in a crowd of strangers. So my Johnny will never be kicked and never be lost in a crowd of strangers. And right now Daenerys is just vibing with him, so that's good. Over here, my Bridget devotional book, brush markers, watercolor brushes, tiny little felt tips, colored pencils underneath the folders that I showed you. But then I forgot to show you, I also have a whole bunch of stickers. So this is my antiquarian sticker book, Bibliophilia, and then the first one, and then this mystical stickers was in my current favorites video that I did a while ago. This is just an amazing Japanese paper book with all kinds of florals in it. So for example, this page is from that book. And then I have this fabulous sticker album. I forget where it's from, but it's the perfect size. What was it? Oh yeah, Lace and Whimsy. They sent it to me along with these stickers and some other ones. So obviously that's really convenient to put the stickers in, and maybe it's a way to get you to buy more, because it means, there we go, there's some non-Lace and Whimsy stickers, and I've got a bunch from Closet Planner Addict as well that I really love. But this certainly makes things easier when you are crafting. Okay, darlings, it is now nearly 5, and I think I'm going to wrap up this vlog here on this very fine Sunday afternoon. Thank you for just having fun in my room with me. That's really all I've done. Subscribe to see more from me. As I said, I am a rainbow witchy creative mess, so if that type of person doing vlogs appeals to you, then like hopefully this one did today, then you can subscribe and stick around for that. Leave a comment below if you want to. That just makes my day, because I love to talk to you guys. And just remember, I love you. Keep going.